Good morning students, today I am going to teach you the topic of commerce which is a part of chapter 1 in class 11 business studies. Let us start with the topic. Now let us at the very first we do the meaning of the word commerce. We all know that the producer and the consumer are the two ultimate persons who are the biggest part in the market. But both of these persons are separated from one and the other due to the long distances. There are certain activities which are performed to bridge the gap between the producer and the consumers so that they can be brought at a single platform, and that one single platform is called the market. We know that all these activities are performed by different persons, and why these persons are performing all these activities, so that whatever the producer has produced can be brought to the ultimate consumer so that it can be consumed, because without consumption there is no use of any production. So these persons are the people who actually brings the goods from the place of producer and makes them available to the ultimate consumer. All those activities which these persons are performing to bridge the gap between the producer and the consumer, these activities are collectively called commerce. So the meaning says that all the economic activities which are carried on in an economy to bridge the gap between producer or seller and the ultimate consumer are called commerce. And the persons who are performing these activities, those persons are known as middlemen. Now middlemen are the people who act as a link between the producer and the consumer, because the main focus of the producer is only the production and main work of the consumer is only the consumption. The producer focuses only on producing goods and services. The work of selling them to the consumer is not a part of the producer's job. So this job is performed by the persons who are known as middlemen, who act as a link between the producer and the last consumer. Now let us classify what are the different categories in trade, in commerce. Now commerce is broadly classified into two categories. One is trade and the other one is auxiliaries to trade. We all know that production is an economic activity in which the goods are produced. But trade is the activity in which the goods are purchased from the place of the producer and they are further transferred to the ultimate consumer in the form of sale. So the trade involves the activities which are concerned with buying and selling of goods from the place of the producer and selling them to the place of the consumer. Those all activities which involve buying from producer and selling to the consumer, all those activities are called trade. And the people who are performing these activities, who are doing these activities, they are called the traders. And the second classification of commerce is auxiliaries to trade. We all know that there are so many obstacles, there are so many problems which a businessman always faces. Now if he is always burdened with all these problems, with all these obstacles, he will never be able to carry on his business very smoothly. Neither the producer is able to carry on the production smoothly, nor the traders are able to carry on their trade very effectively. So there are certain services which are provided by commerce which help in removal of so many hindrances. Hindrances means the obstacles, the problems which come in the way of easy or smooth functioning of the trade. These all services collectively are called auxiliaries to trade or aids to trade. So the network of different services which help in smooth working of trade by removing the various hindrances are called auxiliaries or aids to trade. Now further, we have a sub-classification of the word trade. Now we know that trade means purchasing from one person and selling to the next person. Now trade is also classified into two broad categories. One is the internal trade and the other one is external trade. Now the internal trade is the trade which is carried within the boundaries of one country, within the boundaries or within the territorial areas of one country. That trade is known as the internal trade. It means in the internal trade does not cross the borders of any country. It is carried within the borders of that particular country. So internal trade is the trade which is carried within the domestic territory of a country, and that trade is called the internal trade. Similarly, if internal trade is the trade which is carried within the area of one single country, so there is the other trade which crosses the borders of the country. It means the trade which one country is doing with the other countries of the world, in which the goods and services are crossing the borders of one country, that trade is called the external trade. So the trade which is carried between two or more than two countries is called the external trade. Import, export, they are the part of your external trade. Now further, we come to the classification of the internal trade. We know that internal trade is carried within the boundaries of one country. That is why there are further two categories in the internal trade. That is the wholesale trade and the retail trade. Now we all know a person who is called a wholesaler and the other person who is called a retailer. And because both of these are carrying on the work of trading, both of them are known as traders only. The difference is that the wholesaler buys goods in huge lots in bulk. Bulk means almost the whole quantity what the producer has produced. He buys whatever the producer has produced at the cost price from him and sells them further to the retailer in a little large quantities. A little large quantities means not bulks, but in dozens or in bundles or in cartons or in big boxes. But they are not selling in single units. They are selling in a little bit large quantities to the retailers. It means wholesalers are the persons who are the link between the producer and the retailer. So the trade in which the trader buys goods in bulk from the producer and sells in large quantities to the retailer is called the wholesale trade, and the person who carries this trade is called the wholesaler. Now there is the other link in the chain of this distribution, and that person is known as a retailer. So the trade which is carried on by a retailer, and what a retailer does is he buys goods in some large quantities from the wholesaler and sells them to the ultimate consumer in single units or in very small quantities. So to the ultimate consumer, the goods are sold by the retailer. So the trade in which the trader buys goods in large quantities from the wholesalers and sells in small quantities to the ultimate consumer, to the last consumer, that trade is called the retail trade. And the person who carries on this trade is known as the retailer. Now these are the categories of the internal trade. Now let us move on further to the categories or the classification of the external trade. We already have done the meaning of this trade, that the external trade is the trade in which trade is done between two or more than two countries. It means this is the trade which crosses the borders of one country. Now this external trade is also classified into three categories: export, import and entry port. Now export is the trade in which one country sells its goods and services to the other countries of the world That is called the export. It means the country itself is the seller and other countries of the world are the buyers in export. The second category is import. In this trade, goods and services are purchased by one country from the other countries of the world. Now in this case, a country is buying goods from rest of the world. It means in this case, the country itself is the buyer and rest of the world is the seller. And that trade is called the imports. And there is a third subcategory, and that subcategory is entry port. Now entry port is that external trade in which one country buys goods from some other country and further it sells those goods to the next one more country. Buying from one country and selling to the other country. It means one country is acting as a link or a trader between two different countries. That trade is called the entry port. In export, one country is the seller and the rest of the world is the buyers. In import, our country is the buyer and rest of the world is the seller. And in entry port, our country is a trader which is buying goods from one country and selling to the other country. So these three are the sub classifications of external trade. With this, we finish up with the topic of trade, a part of commerce. Thank you and have a nice day.